brutality won't kill me. Brutality won't kill me. Disturbed my they just beat your ass. they just whoop your ass. They just whip 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 your ass.
See how the news about those missing kids? We're not the only ones looking. Listen.
They just whip your ass. They just whip your ass.
Today I wanted to talk about one of my favorite additions to Mortal Kombat and how she'll likely return in MK11. Whip. Because despite her limited appearance, Scarlet's story extends far beyond whip the events of MK9. Ass. But first, let's talk about what makes Scarlet so special as a character. Much like Ermac, Scarlet's life began as a rumor, and this similarity in origin is reflected in her backstory. Just like Ermac, Scarlet was created from the fallen enemies of Shao Kahn and born a living weapon. But instead of souls, Scarlet is powered by blood, absorbing it through her skin to become stronger, which means the more enemies she slays, the more deadly she becomes. So unlike these thoughts, Scarlet's sexy outfit actually does serve a purpose. And on top of that, Scarlet can also manipulate her blood or the blood of her fallen foes to make weapons. And like her fatality implies, she can even wound herself to create much deadlier weapons, which leads me to believe that Scarlet can likely heal herself as well as long as enemy blood is nearby. And if all that wasn't deadly enough, Scarlet's blood also has AIDS. I'm just kidding. But now let's talk about Scarlet's story after the events of MK9. Fun fact, Scarlet does actually appear in the MK9 cutscenes, to my surprise. But sadly, that's about all she adds to the story in that game. Now, thankfully, she plays a much bigger role in the Mortal Kombat X comics, although her costume does suffer a bit of a downgrade. I understand their goal is to make her less sexy, but when you absorb blood through your skin to become more powerful, covering 95% of your body doesn't make much sense. But I digress. Let's talk about the story. Now, in the comics, Scarlet is revealed to be an agent of Reiko, likely because his power and influence reflect that of her former master, Shao Kahn. Not to mention, the guy does look an awful lot like Shao Kahn to boot. And you see, despite Shao Kahn locking Scarlet up for most of her life, she was still eternally devoted to him. Kind of like Stockholm Syndrome, but on steroids. So after Shao Kahn died, she settled for Diet Shao Kahn. And while serving Reiko, Scarlet makes sure to initiate Cassie Cage and Jackie Briggs like the little new bloods they are. That's pretty brutal, Scarlet. I love it. And Reiko clearly does, too, choosing to share his Kami-Dogu blood magic with her, which, of course, makes her even more OP than she already was. But Scarlet's nothing if not generous, so she shares his new power with Cassie and Jackie, too, which kinda sorta forces them to fight their own family and friends. Hey, man, nothing's free. And once that big battle finally ensues, Scarlet is basically bodying everyone and making sure they all know that she's top tier. That is, until her fateful battle with Devorah, where Scarlet learns the true meaning of a 10-0 matchup. Because even though Devorah does get spanked by Scarlet, her blood is very toxic. So when Scarlet goes to absorb it, things don't go over very well. Now, she does manage to survive, but also suffers a severe nerf. But despite this new low-tier status, Scarlet still finds the strength to confront Melina on the battlefield, and thus the ultimate catfight ensues. And I'm not joking about that either. They're actually fighting over Reiko. To which Melina says, enjoy my sloppy seconds, and with the help of Ermac, Blanca balls her way right through Scarlet's legs. Now, of course, such an injury would be fatal for most warriors, but like Scarlet says, brutality won't kill me. Which is actually a clever in-joke, since this is Melina's actual brutality in the game. So for the time being, Melina settles for knocking Scarlet out and vows to torture her once the battle is over. And that's basically all we know about Scarlet's story for now. So next, let's talk about how Scarlet will likely return in MK11. You see, Melina's battle didn't go exactly as planned, so I think it's very likely that Scarlet managed to escape, possibly absorbing enough blood from the nearby dead soldiers to heal her legs and quite literally walk it off. However, if not, then she's likely in Melina's prison waiting for someone to bust her out, which I think would most likely be Tanya, who is most likely leading the Adenian rebels, who are most likely still intent upon killing Kotal Kahn. And honestly, who better to help out with that than Scarlet? I mean, the chick is practically an anti-military weapon, since every person she kills literally makes her stronger. And also, seeing as how Melina and Reiko were both dead, this is the only path I can imagine her taking. Although we already do know that MK11 will have time travel, which means Scarlet does have the potential of meeting both Melina and Reiko again in the story mode. And if they do all cross paths, can you imagine how awesome the intro dialogue would be? And not just for them, but every other character that Scarlet's interacted with? Forcing Cassie Cage and Jackie Briggs to fight their friends and family? Telling Melina that she's basically not woman enough to satisfy Reiko? And also fighting a bunch of important new characters like Devorah and Kotal Kahn? Scarlet honestly does have so much potential for MK11, so I sincerely do hope the Netherrealm brings her back. She has a very distinct look and playstyle, plus her blood manipulation and origin are very unique. And finally, her interaction with key characters allow for so many story possibilities. If Scarlet does return for MK11, my only request is to give her more blood-based attacks. Because aside from a single projectile and a teleport, she doesn't really do much with these powers. Perhaps she could even make her own weapons out of blood, similar to how Sub-Zero creates ice weapons using his cryomancy. I think that would help to make Scarlet even more distinct as a character. But what do you all think about Scarlet? Would you be excited if she returned in MK11? Please let me know down in the comments. And while you're down there, please leave a like if you enjoyed the video. And then why not keep that combo going by subscribing and ringing that bell? That way you never miss a future video. Make sure to come back next time, and as always, stay underdogs.
Brutality won't the living Why are you spinning that wheel? This can she? Why you spinning that wheel? Johnny Cage. why you spinning that wheel, son? Well, ring the bell, son. Kenshi. What about that? Well, ring the bell, son. Now ring the bell, son. Shut the fuck up. Well, ring the bell, son. Well, ring the bell, son. Eight. Well, ring the bell, son. Well, ring the bell, son. Ring the bell, son. Ring the bell, son. Hey. Ring the... Oh. Ring the bell, son. Tilt. Tilt. AIDS. Possessed Kenshi. You mother. Possessed. Yay. Yeah. Possessed Kenshi.
This is an infest.
Storm. Baraka had it rough. Baraka had it rough. You know what I'm playing? Baraka had it rough. People was and down once, but twice. I like how the moves off. They just whoop your ass. They just whoop your ass. They just whoop your ass. They just whip 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 your ass. Dunk kick. Oh no, I didn't. AIDS. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. They just whip your ass. Take your place inside the fire. They just whip your ass. They just whip your ass. They just whoop 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 your ass. Thank you. they just whoop your ass. They just whoop your ass.